Thank you very much, Administrator Bolden. That is one of the most, my favorite part, actually, of the closing ceremonies. It's a part I look forward to every time I've been able to be part of them. And so each year, the class nominates and elects one of their peers for an almost impossible task, to somehow summarize the shared experiences and memories of the SSP participants during this session, to somehow crystallize 9 weeks of experience in just a few short minutes. This year, the class selected very well. He has a bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering and physics, and is entering the graduate program in astronautics and aeronautics at Stanford University this fall. Currently, he's working at NASA Ames Research Center. His passion in space is to encourage the development of humanity's first permanent off-world settlements. Please welcome Mr. Jonathan Conley, the SSP 12 class speaker.
Well, thank you for the introduction, Gary, and thank you, Administrator Bolden, for what's always an inspiring speech. And I also have to thank the participants of the 2012 class of SSP. It's been such an honor to be selected to speak on behalf of you, but it's even more of an honor to have been part of you this summer, to be there as we made memories together and worked and grew and learned. So to make sure that I represented that honor to the best of my ability, I thought I should talk to one of our distinguished mentors. So I talked to Jim Burke over lunch, and I was asking Jim, you know, what do you think I should say in my speech? I've been elected class speaker. I really want to do a good job. And Jim looks at me and he tells me, well, John, I think you should get up there and you should say how terrible ISU was. He said that would really get their attention. And, you know, even though I think Jim was joking, I thought, you know what, let's go with it. So I think this is the part where people get a little bit worried that they selected me. You know, so ISU has been terrible for me, just very, very terrible. You know, and it's been especially bad for my English. I was in the cafeteria the other day and I wanted to get some potato chips to go with my sandwich, but accidentally asked for crisps instead of chips. It's really embarrassing. I only speak in terms of internet memes now after our Facebook group, so I think when I get home I might make one that says, elected to give class speech, has to follow Charlie Bolden. I'm going to grad school in the fall, and I was really excited about getting back into classes after working for a while, but you know, classes just won't be the same without earth balls for questions, or flying koalas, or the hundreds upon hundreds of slides of black text on white backgrounds. And finally, as a good Californian in the San Francisco Bay Area, I drive a Prius, and it's a hybrid car. It's good gas mileage. So I usually end up driving whenever my friends and I go out for dinner or something. So whenever I'm driving people now, I'm afraid I'm going to be yelling, the Prius will be leaving in 5 minutes. Seriously, though. But ISU has created some really amazing memories. One of the first ones that comes to mind is when we were able to see Atlantis as she was pulled into the VAB for the last time. Enjoying the shadow as she passed overhead, when her wings momentarily blocked the hot Florida sun. And for me, seeing those wings ahead and the shadow passing over me, it was like she was flying again. And it reminded me of what inspired me in my childhood. And of course, we can't forget the two magnificent rocket launches that we saw. And it's so interesting to watch a rocket launch, because you're waiting and you're going through the count, you know, you're listening intently to everything the launch director says, and your heart stops when there's a hold. And finally you get to that final moment, and they're counting down 3, 2, 1. And you're focused on it so hard that you forget to breathe. And you can hear something, but you don't hear it with your ears. And you can feel something in your chest, it's pounding, but it's not your heart, it's the vibrations of this living beast that's about to leave the planet. And I have to think that in those moments when I watch the launch, that I know what astronauts feel as they're sitting on top, waiting to go into the void, waiting on top of this pulsing, vibrating rocket that's like a beast trying to break free of invisible chains. And then it does break free, and it ascends higher and higher. And it ends so quietly and peacefully as it touches space for the first time. And I think it's just such a beautiful moment. I can't wait to experience it myself someday, and I'm sure all of you will. But ISU has created some really strange memories as well. I never thought that I would be there on Pad 39A watching the launch of My Little Rocket, especially with George Diller in the background with the space unicorn flame. I never thought that I would sing and dance to Das Fliegerlied with our distinguished guests and lecturers. And you all have shared some really fun memories with me as well, from going skydiving to flying a plane for the first time to having fun in an EVA pool. And of course, we can't forget the culture nights in NPRB, though we'll leave those stories for ourselves. And so even though tomorrow we go our separate ways and we go back to the 31 countries that we call home, I'll remember you. And I'll remember the times we shared and the friendships that we built together over the past 9 weeks. And I'll never forget that our destination is in the sky above. I've always loved the phrase ad astra, which is used so many times in the space industry. Ad astra means to the stars. And it makes sense because we're going to the stars, right? But after ISU, I feel more connected to space than ever before. And I have to think that there's something missing in that phrase. In our core lectures, we've learned that we actually came from the stars, that the elements that form our bodies were forged in stellar furnaces, that the atoms in our body were spewed across the universe at unimaginable speed and distance, and that even though as humans we were born here, as matter we were born out there in space, in the stars. And so even though I don't speak Latin, I've been told that the phrase should be reverte ad astra, which means return to the stars. And return to take our birthright, we will. And we'll do it together, and we'll do it as a species. Together with the voices of 31 countries and 6 continents, and we can overcome any challenge that faces us. And yes, space is hard. And what we do takes years of effort and enormous resources, and sometimes we lose. Programs are canceled, and sometimes on terrible days, lives are lost. But we're a relentless species. We take our resources and creativity and tools, and we create amazing things. We take rocks and turn them into metal. We take sand and turn it into computers, and water and turn it into rocket fuel. And we put those things together, and then we're able to give ourselves new capabilities to fundamentally change what it means to be human. It's an astounding, incredible time to be alive. Just imagine the amazing things that will happen during our long careers in space. We might see the first humans on Mars. I know that some of us will become astronauts, and it's a lifelong passion. Some of us will get married and start families. We might have incredible successes in our careers. Whenever we achieve whatever it is that makes us happy, I know that we'll be there for each other. And even when the terrible moments do happen, when an accident occurs, or life takes a different turn and we feel lost, I know that we'll be there for each other then too. The friendships and relationships that we've created over the past 9 weeks are strong, and they unite us, even over global distances. When you work in the space industry and you're in astronomical units all the time, a few thousand kilometers is no big deal. And so space is incredibly large. But if space is truly infinite, then so are the possibilities contained within it. And together, we'll build an incredible future, a future of infinite possibilities. So to close, I really want all of us to be speaking together. And so I'll ask you that whenever I say a word, you respond in your native language. And this will be with the participants and whoever else wants to join in. So, for instance, if I said hello, you'd reply bonjour if you spoke French, or hola, Spanish, etc. So if you will, turn to your neighbor and hold their hand, or put your arm around their shoulder, or give them a smile, whatever it is that makes you comfortable. And repeat after me in your own language. Together, as friends, we return to the stars. Thank you.